Unlike most vaccines, which are designed to prevent infections, a therapeutic vaccine is designed to treat an infection that a person already has. Dr. Michael Sneller and his colleagues at the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases are studying whether a therapeutic vaccine can help treat HIV infection.
We're hoping that this vaccine or series of vaccines will boost the individual's immune response to the HIV virus such that they might be able to control the virus without medications.
It'd be super cool if I didn't have to take drugs anymore. That would be awesome. Even to have to get a vaccination like once a month would be way better than having to deal with drugs every day.
The overall goal is to try to find better alternatives to daily drug therapy for HIV. These drugs are very effective, they're life-saving, but many of these medications can have long-term toxicities, and they require that the patient take medication every day for the rest of their life.
HIV can be suppressed by antiretroviral drugs to very low levels. When this happens, special HIV-fighting immune cells decrease in number because the immune system thinks the virus is gone. A therapeutic vaccine would stimulate the immune system in a way that mimics active HIV infection, while antiretroviral medication keeps the real virus suppressed. This strategy could create an army of HIV-fighting immune cells. These immune cells could then attack HIV-infected cells, controlling the virus in the absence of antiretroviral drugs. HIV-infected volunteers come to the NIH Clinical Center in Bethesda, Maryland, to receive either the investigational therapeutic vaccines or saltwater injections called a placebo. No one knows who gets the vaccines and who gets the placebo. The clinical trial has two goals. The first is to learn if the vaccine is safe in people with HIV.
We'll compare the side effects that we see in patients who receive the vaccine with those who received the saltwater placebo. By doing this, we will be able to get a pretty good idea of the overall safety of the vaccine.
The second goal is to learn if the vaccine regimen allows the immune system to control HIV without medication.
After the subjects have completed their series of injections of either placebo or vaccine, we will, under very controlled circumstances, stop their antiretroviral medications and determine if the virus again becomes detectable in the blood.
The reappearance of HIV in the blood is called viral rebound.
We hope that in the individuals who received the vaccine, that their rebound in viremia will be blunted compared to those who received placebo. Or perhaps, under the best of circumstances, the individuals who got the vaccine won't rebound at all.
Volunteers will restart their HIV medications after 16 weeks, or sooner if the level of HIV in their blood increases too much or their immune health changes significantly.
If we get positive results in this study, the next step would be to conduct a much larger trial to confirm the preliminary results that the vaccine is both safe and effective at controlling the virus in the absence of medications.
It'd be awesome to be able to get a shot once a year or once every 6 months. But if this is a stepping stone to that happening one day, then that's excellent.